Once you have your 90-second keto bread, top it off with some great protein. This 6-pack of canned wild albacore will help you with that. Just toss with mayo, salt, and pepper and pile on bread with fresh greens. Buy it, Wild Planet Wild Albacore Tuna, 5-ounce cans, pack of 6 at Amazon. The magic of 90-second keto bread. Here's how it works. You whisk an egg with a little coconut or almond flour and add a pinch of salt and baking powder, oil, and milk. Zap it for 1 minute and 30 seconds in the microwave and you end up with a cylindrical loaf of spongy bread-like stuff. Some recipes use coconut flour, while some use almond flour. Others go unapologetically into biscuit mode and add cheese and herbs. I tried them all. First, I tried using coconut flour only. The batter was very thick and pasty and the resulting bread was very firm and dry, like a really dry biscuit. It did, however, keep its shape well and toasted up evenly golden brown in a skillet with oil. I thought about trying again with more liquid, but that wouldn't solve its fatal flaw, the strong, overwhelming coconut flavor. Even chicken and sun-dried tomato pesto could barely cover it up. Version 2 was almond flour only. Right away I could tell the recipe would need some modifications. Almond flour doesn't soak up nearly as much liquid as coconut flour, resulting in a very soupy batter. I added 2 more tablespoons of almond flour, which was double the amount of coconut flour, and it still wasn't nearly as thick. After its short stint in the microwave, this bread turned out very moist, soft, and rather flimsy, but was pleasantly bland enough to go with any filling I wanted. It just needed a bit more structure, so for trial number 3 I split the difference, using half coconut flour and half almond flour. There's a reason they say the third time's a charm. This was the perfect blend. The bread was moist but firm enough to hold its shape, and it didn't taste like coconut. After that, I began experimenting. Hazelnut flour worked great, and cheese and scallions added great flavor. Keto bread certainly doesn't have the satisfying chew of wheat bread, its texture is a bit more cakey and tender. And it definitely benefits from additional flavors, such as herbs, spices, and cheese. And forget the toaster, the best way to crisp it up is in a little oil in a hot skillet, but be vigilant. It takes less than a minute. I'm not following a keto diet, but I can definitely see adding this super fast high-protein biscuit bread to my morning routine. Even my kids enjoyed it with spoonful of jam.